I want to talk to you first about these scenes in America. You know, you fought in America, you know America well. There have been desperate scenes to watch, haven't they? What is your take on this and on the debate about racism?
I think it's a terrible thing that's happened with the guy who's been choked or whatever has happened to him. Unacceptable behaviour from any colour or any race of people, you know. A lot's been made of it. A lot of riots and stuff's been going on in America. And I think they're trying to make a point where it's very unacceptable and something needs to be done about it. And, you know, I heard that the fella's being trialled for murder, the guy who did it, the police officer. And then, like you were saying before about this blackout stuff, it shouldn't be just a one-day thing, like, oh, let's post a black picture for Tuesday and then forget about it for the other 365 days of the year. It's any day of the week, racism is unacceptable.
Well, Jude Tirora, Tyson, was saying just at the end of that debate, it's very important this isn't just a conversation for a day and it's not just a conversation amongst that community. White people need to be asking themselves those questions. But you have a very specific perspective, don't you, on racism?
I do, because I'm a white male, but I suffer racism in 2020 as a white person because I'm a traveller. I come from an ethnic background, gypsy king traveller. You know, even today, you go into pubs and bars and restaurants and things, and it may say on the door, we reserve the right to not let travellers in, no travellers allowed, gypsies or travellers. So, yeah, it's not just black people who suffer racism. You know, I think travellers are at the most acceptable form of racism in Britain and in the world at the moment. Mm. It's still acceptable to be racist towards travellers. Nothing ever gets done about it. No one ever says anything. It's just accepted. That's it. It is what it is.
And how does it make you, Tyson, how does that make you... It's obviously a different thing, but in the way they're connected, how does it make you feel to be marginalised in that way?
You know, it's terrible because you can't judge everybody with the same brush. You can't tar them with the same brush. And to have such things go on in my life and everything that I've been through, and then to see that on doors and whatever, and to even be refused as a person, not as an ethnic group or whatever, as a person I've been refused entry even when I was World Heavyweight Champion. And it was like, what? Are you serious?
Where was that?
This was like 2016. Me and Paris went to go in was it a restaurant or a bar, Paris?
It was like a restaurant bar.
And they said, oh, no gypsies allowed. I said, what are you talking about? They said, oh, no gypsies allowed. I said, I'm a heavyweight world champion boxer representing this country. I said, I'm not just some gypsy. And when she went, well, you are a traveller, aren't you? I said, yeah. Well, she did say, no travellers allowed. I was like, OK, thank you very much. Wow. See you in a bit.
Where so, was that?
I'm not going to go into it because I don't want to cause any problem for the business. And
but in this country or in America?
Yeah, in this country.
This country.
In England. So, you know, I know what it feels like to be racist towards. Unacceptable behaviour at any time of the year and from anybody. And it ain't just whites and blacks and browns who are racist. I think, you know, anyone can be a racist person. Any colour, any background, it doesn't matter. You know, you can see it and it needs to change.
Yeah, if you look at any group of people in a way where you consider yourself superior, then there's something wrong with you. Frank, let's get to something a little more cheerful, boxing. The super fight everybody wants, your man against Anthony Joshua. Is this fight going to happen?
Look, we got no problem with it. We signed an NDA with some people, a country that's hopefully about to make an offer. We want the fight to happen. Tyson, speak for himself. I know he wants to fight. But I don't think the other side do. I think it's just lip service. We want to get it on. The British public want to see it. But I just got a feeling in my bones and I'm hearing behind the scenes that they don't really want the fight.
How safe is it to... Obviously, boxing is a full contact sport. You exchange fluids, you know, you're punching each other and so on. How safe is it to bring back boxing in the coronavirus era?
Well, I think we've thoroughly investigated. It's the British Boxing Board of Control as well, with eminent doctors and so forth. We've got all the safety precautions in place, and I believe there'll be boxing behind closed doors sometime in July. You're quite right, it is a contact sport between two participants, but they'll be tested going into it, they'll be tested afterwards, they'll be tested leading up to the fight, they'll go through all the medical protocols, so they will not be, if they're either of them are showing any signs of the symptoms, then they just will not be allowed to fight.
The trouble is, of course, that there is a chance that, you know, you could pick up an infection between tests. That's the issue, isn't it? And I can't imagine, I mean, just looking at boxing, I can't imagine a sport where more bodily fluid, you know, is emerging, you know, in full contact. Is testing the only way? I mean, practically, realistically, is testing the only way that you can really make it as safe as possible? And do you think that that will be accepted?
Well, there will be. Obviously, there'll be a situation through the boxers' training with the gymnasiums, ensuring that they're cleaned regularly. They're, again, people are tested there, the trainers are tested. Regarding the fighters, who are the most important people in this and the ones who are most vulnerable, it'll be a situation where they'll be tested at least 2 weeks leading up to the fight, tested all the way through leading up to the weigh-in, tested at the weigh-in, tested before the fight. You can't do no more than that. They'll be in lockdown prior to the fight happening. We'll not be mixing with anybody, only with their trainer, will also be going through the same process. So we're fairly confident that side of it will be looked after.
Tyson, if I can bring Tyson, sorry. Tyson, are you worried about the coronavirus issue?
You know, it's a real issue, isn't it? You know, I don't think we've forgotten how damaging it's been to the world over the last few months. It seems like I was in Las Vegas 1 minute fighting Deontay Wilder. I've came back home and the world's totally ended for a bit. Very, very serious. A lot of people have died. So, you know, I'm not sure what the protocol will be for getting back in the ring anytime soon.
If you do, I presume you can't wait to get at Anthony Joshua.
Well, there's all these words of Anthony Joshua and all these other opponents, but old Deontay Wilder's still got his third fight that he has to take. So, yeah,
Is he actually going to go through with that? Because that last one, you took him to school, and I don't think he can get back out.
Well, he will do, and he'll take the fight for one pure reason, and it's called money. he'll take the fight because a hell of a lot of money on the table, and he's got, I think he's got 8 or 9 kids to feed, so, you know, he'll definitely take the rematch. And, you know, it's heavyweight boxing. Anything can happen, as we've seen, especially with a dynamite puncher like Wilder.
And finally, Tyson, how are you finding lockdown? We've checked in with you a few times.
You're looking very fit.
It's dragged on a bit, hasn't it, for everybody? How are you finding it?
Yeah, I'm finding it... there's been positives and negatives throughout the whole thing for me and my family, but the most positive thing is I've been doing the workouts every day since it started, wow. Since we spoke. I have not had any time out. Me and Paris have been doing our best to keep everyone happy and keep everybody fit. We're even going to do one this morning at 9 a.m. So, all the viewers can join in if they want to. It's been, it's given me a lot of time to spend with my family. It's given me a lot of time to think about what's important in my life, what I want going forward, and how not to take things for granted anymore. And I think a lot of people around the world be in the same boat as
us. Hasn't it just? I really think it's that, isn't it?
You and I have talked about weight a number of times in the past, Tyson, but you look like you haven't put on the COVID stone. Is that true?
That's very true, yeah. I boxed Deontay Wilder around about 19 stone 7 last time, and I'm probably about 19 stone 5 today. So, yeah, I've not put on any
weight. You've actually lost weight in lockdown?
Yeah, I've lost a couple of pounds, but I have been training 4 times a day. So,
I think I started lockdown lockdown, Tyson, around the sort of 16 stone mark, and I've got to where your old weight was, 28 stone. What it feels like to me.
Well done.
It's great to talk to you. Please stay in touch. I can't wait for that fight, and hopefully we can get it on, and you'll deal with Wilder again. I mean, I'd be amazed if he wants to put himself through that again, but if he does, good luck to him.